Time to Hunt's interesting because it's quite a long movie. It's over 2 hours. And I think that is one of the major faults of the film. But I liked a lot about this. It's a dystopian crime thriller in like a near future South Korea. It's a Korean film. It's directed by Yoon Sung-hoon, who burst out in the Korean film scene a lot, like several years ago, with this movie called Bleak Night. That got a lot of love over there. Didn't get distribution over here. And this is really his first film since. And it's kind of notable because you have Lee Jae-hoon as one of the lead actors. He was big in this Korean show called Signal that, again, really popular over there. And, of course, Choi Woo-sik is in this. He was, I think, most recognizable to everyone as Kevin from Parasite. And he's also in Train to Busan as well, which is a well-liked Korean horror movie. So I think those two faces have kind of like gotten hype for the movie for people that are aware of it. And it debuted at Berlin back in February and was supposed to be released in theaters, and then coronavirus happens, obviously. And then funny enough, it was supposed to be on Netflix back on April 10th, but there was a suit between the distributor and the production company over, like, you know, sales being made for distribution, blah, 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 got held up. Either way, they settled. Just came out this past Friday on Netflix. And, you know, it's funny because the director, he was actually born in America, and you kind of see a lot of the American film influence on this movie. There's a lot of like really obvious like establishing drone shots and stuff. And I think just the overall like appetite for action and gunplay, which is, I think, kind of uncommon for Korean movies, which kind of has a different relationship to guns over there than we do here. And I think that's kind of this like cool like meta thing. Like you can kind of see the American influence. But either way, it's kind of a simple film where in this dystopian world, Korea, where Korean currency has tanked so badly that there's really little hope for most people in the world. These four buddies decide to rob a illegal casino so they can have money to move away. And they succeed, but then they get hunted as a result. And that's really the premise. And, you know, I think the movie does drag a little bit due to its length and starts to spin its wheel in a certain sense. And the characters, I guess, don't really grow all that much, but I really liked how it sets itself up. You know, it takes like a good 20 minutes to get to the actual heist. So you get to spend some time with those characters. And then ultimately, kind of what I really liked was there's just these really well-made set pieces where, whether you're in this parking garage or in a hospital, and the color palette's really varied, and we actually get some like psychological aspects to these characters as they're grappling with being hunted and losing people and stuff. And ultimately, I guess the script's a little similar to Extraction, the ultimate part of the story. It's kind of hard to believe some of the things, but the movie's so committed to its its world, and you kind of believe that you're in these like abandoned office parks and empty hospitals and all these kind of things, right? And I did like these actors, so yeah, I liked it a lot. But it's a little long.
Yeah, I was gonna check it out. I didn't have enough time because I had like a hour and a half window, and I was like, you know, maybe I can stretch that hour 40, or like maybe skip through a couple parts of it. It's like a little slow, but I was like, 2 hours 14 minutes feels like a lot to sit through. However, I did check out bits and pieces of like the first like third of it. And I agree. I think parts of, like, the sparseness of the world feels very unbelievable at times. That was like my main thing I noticed, was like, wow, there's really no one around here until they go to the casino. But I really enjoyed, from what I've seen so far, like you said, the color palette of it like feels very cool, and also like the relationships between all the characters. I kind of like the especially I'm not totally remembering their names, but the buddy who I got to the part right before they leave after the and the buddy who's like offering to like take me and offering that, he's like, yeah, of course. The relationship was really built up well, and I'm interested to see how the rest of that goes. But just didn't have enough time to finish this yet. So you got me in, Dave. I want to finish it now. I want to go see how it ends. Definitely worth checking out.
Yeah. There's also this moment where a character is giving a monologue where I expect him to say "Time to Hunt," the title, and I'm like, oh, we're getting the Rick Dalton meme. He's got a point. And he doesn't actually say it. And I'm like, ah, shit. It was right there.
I love that Rick Dalton meme, by the way. Just fantastic stuff. Give me more Rick Dalton.